Hi everyone, welcome to Video Academy. My name is Mr. Cyril. Today I'm going to show you how to install Oracle Linux 8.8.4. Okay, Oracle Linux 8.4 on Oracle VirtualBox 6.1. Okay, so the agenda of this session will be divided into four steps. Okay, the first steps will be to download and install Oracle VirtualBox 6.1, which I'm not going to do the download. The second step is to download Oracle Linux 8.4 ISO file from Oracle eDelivery website. Okay, and the third step will be to create a new virtual machine, and then last start the installation. So the first two steps I'm not going to do. I've done it already in another video, so you can search that in my YouTube channel. So I will immediately go with the third steps. Okay, so I have Oracle VirtualBox already installed on my PC. The version I'm using is 6.1.22. okay, so this is my Oracle VirtualBox version. Okay, so what we are gonna do is I have already downloaded the software also, so I've kept the software here. This is the location, the software. Okay, downloaded from eDelivery. So what I'm gonna do immediately is to go ahead and create a new virtual machine. Okay, so this virtual machine I will call it Node 2. Okay, because I have another VM already, Node 1. Okay, so I'm going to create OEM 8 Node 2. So here I will go and select directly the directory where I'm going to store the file. It's like a base directory for this VM. Okay, so I'm going to create Node 2. So I need to create the directory here. OEL 8 Node 2. Okay, this is the location where I'm going to keep this file. So I have given the name of my VM and I've given the location where I'm going to store the file. Okay, then click next. Here I will be assigned 4 GB RAM. Okay, 4096, which is 4 GB RAM. Okay, then click next. Don't do anything here. Create virtual hard disk now. This is fine. This is perfectly fine. You create. Here also, you no need to do anything. Virtual disk image. This is correct. So click next. And here, dynamic allocation. Okay, we are going for dynamic allocation. We are not pre-allocating the size, so the space. Okay, click next. And here, I will be giving 150 GB. Okay, 150 GB storage, then create. Okay, create this one. So here we need to, before starting, we need to go to setting. Okay, this is very important. You need to listen carefully. Okay, you go to advanced tab. In the advanced tab, you will see share clipboard or drag and drop. Okay, here you will give bidirectional on both. This will allow us to copy from our virtual machine to our physical machine. Okay, or we can copy also from our personal laptop to our virtual machine on VirtualBox. Okay, so this is the meaning of bidirectional on both. So both sides we can do. From VM to PC, or to from PC to virtual machine. Okay, this is fine. So description, no need to change anything here. You keep description. You can add the description of your virtual machine. You can add anything. This is fine. So here you, in the system setting, you need to uncheck this floppy. Okay, make sure you haven't checked this. Go to processor. In the processor size, I'm going to give 4 virtual processor here for this VM. Okay, So for this VM, I'm going to keep 4 virtual processors. I'm having 12, so I will allocate for this VM. Okay. Then display, in the display, no need to change anything. You keep it as default. Okay. This is perfectly fine. Recording also, no need to change anything. Remote display, no need to change anything. Let's go to storage. At the storage part, we need to allocate here. You need to choose which software, which ISO file we are going to use. Here, I'm choosing this one. Okay. This is my Oracle Linux 8.4 that I'm selecting here. Then click open. So this is the installation software of my virtual machine. Okay. Next, you go to audio. Here, no need to change anything. Let's go to network. In the network part, the first network adapter should be set as bridge. Okay. So bridge will be our first network card. Bridge adapter will allow you to access internet where you are personal laptop, your physical machine. So this network adapter will be in the same network as your physical machine. Okay. Adapter 2, I'm going to add another adapter. This one, in this case, this will be NAT. The NAT adapter will allow the communication between the VM on VirtualBox. Okay, so all VM in the VirtualBox will be able to communicate using this private network. Okay, adapter 3, I'm adding another one more adapter 3, NAT, same. Okay, go to serial port, no need to change anything. USB, no need to change anything here. Share folder. The share folder will allow me to share file from my PC to my virtual machine. So here I'm going to select which folder I'm going to share with my virtual machine. Here I have one shared drive here. I'll select this one. Okay. Now, where I'm going to mount this share? This share, I will be mounting it on mnt/share on my virtual machine. So on my Linux virtual machine, this will be created, and then whatever is available in the /share in my F drive will be shared, will be mounted to this share drive. I can mount it on read only, or I can keep it read write. Okay, auto mount means when I restart my virtual machine, this will be automatically mounted. Okay. So these two settings, okay. So user interface, no need to change anything here, and then you hit okay. Now we can go ahead and start our virtual machine, and then start the installation. You click on start. Okay. So our virtual machine is going to start. Let's select the installation software that we selected during the creation of the VM, then hit start. So the installation is going to start here. Hit enter to start installation. So in the first step, it's going to check my ISO file for any corruption. Okay. You can see here it's checking if there is any corruption. I can also decide to skip. Okay, I'm going to skip here by pressing escape keyboard. Okay, this will skip the check. This because I have already checked, so I know that there is no corruption. Okay, for you, you can check till the end. So now the installation is going on. Okay. So here what we will do, we will select English USA by default. This is perfectly fine. Okay, I will go with the default. I click continue. Okay, So here we need to select keyboard. This is fine. This is already selected. This is USA. Now the installation source. Okay, the local media. This is fine. This is already selected. The language also, no need to change anything here. The time, I need to go and select my location, local time zone. Okay, here I'm sitting in Qatar, so I will select here Qatar and then hit done. Now the software installation here by default it's server with GUI. Okay, we will select server with GUI and we will select few more packages. Okay, we are going to select system tool. You select system tool, you select security. Okay, you select also container and management. Okay, if you are going to create container on your virtual machine, you select this container. And then development tool, where is development tool? We select also, where is the development tool? Development tool, okay, selected. So we select container management, development tool, we select security tool, you select system tool. So container management is in case you are going to run containerization, create like Docker or whatever. Okay, so here we are not going to run any containerization. Okay, so I can uncheck this. It's perfectly fine. If you select also, packages will be installed also. So I hit done. This is done. Okay, now the next step is to select the disk. So this is my 150 GB where I'm going to install my virtual machine. Okay, the virtual machine software. Okay, so here I can decide to go for automatic partitioning. Okay, if I keep default automatic partitioning, this will automatically do the partition for me. Okay, with the default partition. So in my case, I'm going to do the partition myself. So I'm not going to go with automatic partitioning. So I will go with custom. Okay, then hit done. Here now we are going to create the partition manually. Okay, the first partition I'm going to create, I will first create swap. This is 8 GB. Okay, because I have given 4 GB RAM, so I'm selecting 8 GB swap, like 2 times my RAM. Okay, add this swap. Here we select standard. Okay, the swap is standard, not LVM. Okay, so here I will be adding the boot partition. The boot partition, I keep 1 GB. 1 GB is enough for the boot partition. Okay, I click OK. So the next will be custom mount point. So I'm going to create 2 mount points. U01 with size 35 GB. Okay, and I'm going to create also U02 with the size also 35 GB. So if I'm going to install Oracle database with grid infrastructure, U01, I will use U01 for grid home, and then I will use U02 for Oracle RDBMS Oracle database software installation. Okay, now you click next. So the remaining will be slash. Okay, the slash mount point, I will give the remaining disk space. So I will be giving 75 GB, the remaining space, available space. So here we have our slash 69, we have boot 1 GB, we have swap 8 GB, we have U01, U02 32 GB, U01. Okay, I'm still having 6 GB, so I will give 40 GB here. Okay, I will give let's say 37 GB space there. Okay, so this is done. Then I click OK. Done. Accept the change. Okay, I'm going to set my root password. Root. Set some password. Okay. Done. Done. Okay. So all setting done. Keydump. Don't need to change anything here. Keep it as default. Network. In the network part, I'm going to give the host name here. The host name, I will call it OEL node2.pidoa.com. Okay, this is the host name I'm giving for this PC. OEL 8. So I will keep 8 here. OEL 8 node2. Okay. Apply. Here I will enable the Ethernet network card. Enable all network card here. I enable all. Enable all. So the first network card, you can see the IP. The IP will be in the range 10.1. 10.1 is actually my wireless network. Okay. So with this IP, my virtual machine will be able to connect to internet. Click done. So all this set properly. Now we can hit begin the installation. So the installation, you can see the partition creation. Okay, it's going on. Now it's starting the package installation, downloading the packages. So we'll wait for some time. This will take around 5 to 10 minutes. So after this, we'll continue with the reboot and the installation. So let's wait for some time. So the installation is going on. 70 packages out of 1518 packages. So it's pretty much faster. You can see that now we are running 204 packages installation. So we can see that the installation is almost done. Okay, we are now in the configuration stage. Let's wait a few more seconds and see. So the installation is almost done. Okay, so we are just going to wait for a few more seconds. So now the post installation script is running now. So it's running the post installation script. Okay, installation done. Now we'll proceed and reboot. Okay, we click on reboot. Reboot system. Okay, so it's rebooting now. Okay, reboot done. So we'll go and accept license agreement. Okay, accept license agreement done. And now user creation. Okay, we'll create user here. will create Fedora. Okay, create user Fedora with some password. Some password. Okay, hit okay, done. Click done. Now finish the configuration. Okay, configuration done. Let's login now. Fedora. Okay, now we are connected. Click next, next, next. Then we can skip this. Start using Oracle. So what we'll do, we come here and let's start our terminal. Okay, the first thing, let's check if you have access to internet. Ping google.com. yes, we have access to internet. This is because we added the first network card as bridge. Okay, now we can see that we are not able to resize the, our virtual machine is not resizing dynamically, okay, automatically. So we need to install additional guest packages. Okay, so what I will do, I will log in as root. So now I log in as root. Okay, we are going to install additional packages. Okay, so what we will do, we will come here, device, install additional packages. Okay, then we hit on, give root password. Okay, so you can see that it's failing here. So VirtualBox additional guest is failing here. Okay, to fix this issue, you need to run below command. Okay, I will show you how to fix this. Go here, start cmd. Okay, and then logging as root, or you can use sudo. Okay, then you run the DNF install. Run this. Okay. So after this, we run this command, yum install kernel uak dev. Okay, uname -r. So I'm installing additional kernel packages. Okay. Install. Yes. Proceed. Yes. Proceed. So now what we'll do, we'll try again and see. Good. And I will mount the, I will insert the Guest additional drive. Now you run this. Hit enter. Now it's working. It's working perfectly. Okay. Currently, we can see that it's not, we cannot resize. Okay. It's not enabled. It's disabled. After installing these packages, we will check again. We will reboot our server and then our virtual machine and then we will check again. See, it will be enabled. Okay. So let's wait for the installation. Complete, and then we'll proceed with the reboot. Okay, installation done. Now we are going to reboot our virtual machine. Okay, now let log in. We first log in and then now you can see that it's enabled. Okay, auto resize quest is enabled. So our VM can resize, can automatically resize. Okay. So you can see auto resize, it's working perfectly. Okay, so with that being said, we are going to close with this session. Thank you and see you on the next video. Bye.